Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of bad valve stem seals. Valve stem seals allow a small metered amount of oil past the seals to lubricate the valve stems and also prevent additional oil from flowing into the cylinders. So when talking about valve stem seals, there is going to be one seal for each valve that you have in the engine, which means internal combustion engines can have a lot of valves and a lot of valve stem seals. For example, if we talk about a double overhead cam V8 engine, there are going to be 32 valves in the engine, which means 32 valve stem seals. So with the number of components there, that does leave a lot of room for potential failure and leaking and bad valve stem seals. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common signs and symptoms of a failing valve stem seal. Symptom number one on our list is a bluish gray smoke from the exhaust. When we talk about bluish gray smoke from the exhaust tips, one thing specifically to look for is on a cold start after the vehicle has been sitting for 6, 8, 12 hours, or just overnight, what tends to occur is there will be some built-up oil that remains in the cylinder head around the valve stem seals. When you actually go to fire up the vehicle, that oil will then be pulled past a failing or leaking valve stem seal into the combustion chambers. When that oil burns off, that is actually what produces that bluish gray smoke. Once that excess oil is gone from the area, the smoke will typically reside and will no longer be a symptom. One important thing to mention here is bluish gray smoke from the exhaust ultimately just indicates that oil is entering the combustion chamber and being burned off. So if you're seeing that, it's not always a dead giveaway that the valve stem seals are problematic, but certainly something to be considered. The valve stem seals can be a very likely culprit. Moving on to number two for the most common signs and symptoms of bad valve stem seals, we have that same bluish gray smoke coming after extended periods of idling and then accelerating. Pretty much the same bluish gray smoke that you will see on a cold start. However, when you're driving your vehicle and you let it idle for an extended period of time, let's say you're at maybe a long red light that you're stuck at for a minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, while you're sitting there at the red light, that oil will start building up and pooling up a little bit inside of the cylinder head right around those valve stem seals. So then when you go to accelerate, all of a sudden the oil can be pulled down past the bad valve stem seal into the cylinder, where it then burns off and produces that bluish gray smoke. It can be tough when you're driving around with other vehicles on the road. One easy way to test this is just simply on a quiet road or a neighborhood street. Just let your car idle for 2 or 3 minutes and then have someone stand behind your vehicle as you then hit the gas and go to accelerate off and see if that bluish gray smoke is present from the exhaust. If you are running into that again, that's another very common sign and symptom that you very well may have a leaking and bad valve stem seal. Moving on to our third symptom, we have excess oil consumption, tying into what I discussed with the bluish gray smoke. That smoke really originates from the oil being pulled down into the combustion chamber and being burned off. When that oil is burned off, that is going to result in your engine losing some oil and ultimately lead to excess oil consumption. So if you notice that your vehicle is suddenly burning through more oil than usual, you check under the car, you check the engine bay, you don't see any visible leaks, then that likely means that you are having oil that is burning internally in the engine. So that would be a good time to do some of these tests again. Try idling the vehicle for a few minutes and then accelerating, see if you get that bluish gray smoke, or fire it up on a cold start and see if you're getting that smoke initially right off the bat after the vehicle has sat overnight. And if that all comes together and you're having some of those symptoms, excess oil consumption, as well as that smoke during those very specific times, then that can really help point you in the right direction and confirm that the valve stem seals are one of the most likely culprits. Ultimately, those three symptoms I just ran through are really the biggest things to be on the lookout for with bad or leaking valve stem seals. It it can be very challenging to diagnose since there are a lot of different problems within internal combustion engines that can cause excess oil consumption and oil being burned off in the cylinders, and therefore that same bluish gray smoke from the exhaust tips, and a few other things to be on the lookout for, issues like worn piston rings, faulty turbochargers. And so one way to eliminate some of those issues is doing a compression and leak down test on the engine. Bad valve stem seals will not cause low compression. So if you run, let's say, a compression test and one of your cylinders is low on compression, then you can likely eliminate the valve stem seals, unless that's a separate issue that's also occurring. But ultimately, if you're getting low compression, that likely points towards something else, like a valve that isn't seating properly or worn piston rings. As a final note, when it comes to replacing the valve stem seals, unfortunately, this is a very labor-intensive and very expensive job. The valve stem seals themselves are very inexpensive. You can expect to spend about $5 to $10 per valve stem seal, or roughly about $100 to $200 for a set of those valve stem seals. So when it comes to the parts, relatively inexpensive, but it does require opening up the cylinder head and disassembling the cylinder head to some extent to actually replace the valve stem seals, which is where all of the labor comes into play and can easily be a job that takes 8, 12, 15 plus hours. And so oftentimes labor costs are going to run about $1,000 to $2,000. And while you do have the valve cover off, it is generally recommended to go ahead and replace every single one of the valve stem seals. It won't add that much additional cost, especially because the parts are inexpensive and can prevent you from running into a failure with another valve stem seal months or even a year later. So generally good to replace them all. But again, unfortunately, this is something that often turns into a $1,500 plus job due to the labor involved in replacing the valve stem seals. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.